Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I'm Coach Lauderdale, and today I am going to do a variety of push-ups. I'm going to start from beginner, move on to intermediate, and to advanced. Some of these push-ups I have never done before, but I've seen some different videos and I've seen what they look like. So I have my laptop set up, so from time to time I will be looking back and checking it out.
So here's a list of the push-ups that I'm going to do.
The ones in white are the ones that I've done before, and the ones highlighted in yellow are the ones that I have not done before.
So this list is going all the way to 64. I'm going to keep number 64 a secret until the end.
Leave a comment down below. What do you think number 64 is? I'll even give you a hint.
Dribbling, has to put it up with the buzzer, banks it in! Oh, he banks in the three!
Push-up that I was unsuccessful in doing, I will move on to the next one, and then later on I will double back and see if I can do it. So if you're ready, we're going to go ahead and begin in 3, 2, and 1.
Feel free to follow along and do the push-ups as I do them. I purposely did the video so you'll be able to follow along. Instead of it being fast-paced, there are chances to rest and recover, so you can follow along with me as I demonstrate the numerous push-up variations. You can watch me then perform the push-up I just demonstrated, do push-ups that you are interested in, or ride along with me. Either way, just give it your best effort. You'll see that I surprised myself with being able to do some push-ups that I've never tried before, and you may shock yourself as well. As you watch the video, be sure to leave some comments down below. What push-ups do you enjoy doing? Which push-ups do you find to be the most challenging? You can also leave a comment stating which push-ups should have made the list, or what push-up you would want me to try. And when I create another push-up video, I'll include those in it. And if you like this video, feel free to hit that like button. And you can also subscribe so you can receive a notification every time I upload a new video and help me increase my sub count.
Ryan Little.
Now we're going to move into the intermediate push-ups. So it's going to get a little bit more challenging. Feel free to get some water and then join back in when you're ready. And we're going to start with the decline push-up. So you can do it with either your feet on a chair or you can prop your feet on a bed. Next push-up is going to be a wall push-up. If you're a child, please do not do this one without your parents' permission. Please get their permission first. I know it's kind of hard. You want to put your feet on the wall, do what I'm doing. However, I am not giving you permission to do this. So ask your parents permission. Put some socks on if possible, or you just take your socks off, but ask your parents permission. Please don't tell your parents that Coach Lauderdale gave you permission to do that. I did not do that. So while I go check on the camera, go ahead and leave a comment down below. What was your favorite push-up and why? So far, my favorite push-up was the typewriter, and I would also say the archer. And that's because those two exercises, you are going side to side instead of going down and up like the other traditional push-ups. It just demonstrates how you're able to work your pectoral muscles in different ways. And your pectoral muscles are the muscles located around your chest. All right, so let's get back into it. The next push-up is the kneeling rocker, and it's kind of like a horse standing on two legs, so you're just pushing and then rocking back up. And then the next one is going to be the rocker push-ups, which is done differently by lifting your knees up. Now we're going to move to the advanced push-ups. So go ahead and take a break if you need to take the break, and then come back whenever you're ready. The advanced push-ups are going to challenge you even more. They're going to challenge your strength, endurance, and your mental toughness. But just try it and stick with it and do the best that you can. Who knows? After the first or second attempt, you may get it right on the third time. So just try and try again. And if you're not able to do it on today, just continue building up, working on your push-ups with the ones that you are able to do. And then over the course of time, you will become stronger. And then you'll be able to do the push-ups that you found challenging to do today. I'm only able to do the push-ups now because of what I did in the past. And as I got stronger day by day, I was able to do push-ups that I haven't tried before. But because I have practiced other types, I am able to do them. So as you see, I caught a cramp in my hip flexors. And hip flexors are a group of muscles near the top of your thighs that allow for your legs to move. So they allow for you to walk, kick, and bend. And because they help bend, it is going to be difficult to do the Aztec push-up because I have to bend my legs closer to my hands in order to touch my ankles. So because that was cramping up, I was in pain, it made the Aztec push-up a lot more difficult because it was uncomfortable fighting through the pain. So I could have used this as an excuse to stop. However, I just tried to massage it out and then continue on and doing the best that I could. And as you see, I was able to get it. Sometimes you just have to fight through that pain, that discomfort, to achieve your goal. So quick little story. My dad retired from the Army after serving 20 years. And one thing that they taught him was never to make excuses. And as a result of them teaching him that, he also taught myself and my brothers and sisters. I was the youngest, so I kind of had a little bit more leeway, but there is never anything I could say to him that would suffice as an excuse as to why I couldn't do something. For example, why I didn't do some homework, why I didn't make a good grade on the test, or if I missed the bus. And at the time, I thought that he was being harsh and didn't understand where I was coming from. But in reality, he was just trying to make me a stronger person. Because at the time, I felt that it was a legitimate reason. But in reality, it really was an excuse because there was a way I could have worked around the situation to get whatever it was done. The reason why it didn't get done was because I didn't want it to get done. And that was either because I was being lazy or I was more interested in doing other things like playing video games or playing outside until the streetlights came on. There's always going to be different situations and challenges that come your way. But in those situations, you can always overcome them by putting your mind and energy towards it and not only setting effective goals, but working to get it done. In this situation, for working through a cramp, I simply massaged it a little bit until I was able to perform. If the cramp got worse, I could have taken more time to stretch it out instead of rushing to get back into it. The best advice I've ever received is slow is fast. So in some situations, it's best to move at a slower pace in order to get more accomplished. It's kind of like the tortoise and the hare. Thank you for continuing to watch the video this far. And while I'm getting ready to perform the next set of the push-ups, feel free to go ahead and leave a comment down below. What's your favorite push-up? What's the most difficult push-up? And then what do you think? And then what do you think that the 64th push-up is going to be? And if you enjoyed the video, and if you like the video, go ahead and click that like button. And you can help me grow my channel by subscribing, and you'll receive a notification. That way you don't miss a single video.
times I did that. I did the cookie push-up the first time I tried. I'm gonna stop right there. Move on. Done the one-off push-up before, so. Get some other ideas of different types of push-ups that you can do. And believe it or not, some of the kids that you're teaching or the kids that you have, they're able to do more than just the regular push-ups. So challenging them to do more so then they can develop their confidence and get stronger. And as always, if you like the video, go ahead and hit that like button. You can always subscribe so you can get some upcoming videos. Till next time, I'm going to end this video doing my favorite push-ups. And these are three-way push-ups. So I hope that y'all have a good one. I'll see you all next time.
In honor of Kobe Dean Bryant, aka the Black Mamba and Gianna, I'm going to do the Kobe one more time.
Yeah, I think about it.
R.I.P. Kobe and Gianna.
It's all the way for Kobe.
Artest looking, gets it to Bryant. Bryant dribbling, has to put it up at the buzzer. Banks it in! Ha-ha! He banks in the three!